Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to a new video in this series, Advanced Development in Grasshopper, where I would like to teach you how to do error handling inside of native Grasshopper component. So how does that look like? If you remember from the previous video in error handling and a card should be popping up here, when we do this in C# scripting, what we do is we use the component property of C# script components to access the functionality of the component that we're living in, and we call add runtime message with all this other stuff. And the method is going to be super similar in if we do it natively. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to replicate this remove item component that we did in previous examples, where what we do is we check if the index that we are given is out of bounds for the removal, and if it is, we display a message and we output a list that has had no changes on it. All right, so I have gone ahead and done a test implementation of this, where I have created in the data components, I have created a remove item component class. I fill in all the properties, the names, whatever. I created an input, the first one, which is a list. You can see it here, and it's generic because I don't care what type of data is going to come in through the list. And then the second input is going to be an integer, which is going to be just a single one. Okay. And the output is also going to be a list with an access with a list as an accessed output. And then it's also going to be generic because it's going to be whichever the same type, it doesn't matter. And I have gone ahead and in the solver instance, I have created the placeholder variables to take in the input data, and I'm retrieving the input data using the data access argument. All right, so we have that. And this is the code, the original code that we have in the C# script component. So how are we going to do this? Well, it's going to be very easy. What I'm going to do is I'm going to adapt this code to the native Grasshopper way. And the way that works is that, first of all, instead of referring to the component of property, which if you remember was something that was part of the properties of a C# script component, and it was basically a way to tell the component how to be able to access its own properties. If we're doing native, we actually don't need this at all because we are already inside of the component. And because we don't have all the additional C# scripting overhead, we are working directly at the Grasshopper component level. All this functionality is already part of being a Grasshopper component. What that means is that if I replace this with the word this, meaning I want to add a runtime this to where I am, or simply altogether just remove it, this method, it's already part of the scope of the class that I am subclassing when I create new components. So I like to go for the this dot because I find it a bit cleaner so that I see where things are coming from. You can see that it's clearly coming from the class. And then I just do the exact same thing, runtime message level of the warning type and with the message that I want to output. The only difference is that here, what I did in C# script is to set the output to the list without any changes and then stop execution of the component. Here, we don't set this way. If you remember, what we do is we say da.setDataList, and then for the output 0 is going to be L, the list that I loaded with no modifications. But if I actually pass this test, and the thing is correct, then what I would need to do is I would need to remove the element at that position, so that works fine, and also to output it in the same way. So I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to output the list that has already had that element modified. So let me run this and see if it works. So let's give this a try. So I'm going to okay, I'm going to take components. I'm going to take this full data tree that I have here, and I'm going to go to data, remove item, and remove, for example, I'm going to remove the first item of the list. And you can see that because I chose lists as an input, the component is working with each one, it's executing once for each list. So I'm with the first one, the second one, the third one, the fourth one, and now boom. At this point, number four is out of bounds, so I'm getting that error message. And then anywhere after that, I still get the error message and I'm getting the exact same output without any modifications. All right? So piece of cake. It's just simply finding where this method was inside of native Grasshopper components, which at this point is really in the scope of the class that we are subclassing. If we were to go to Grasshopper components, so maybe even here in the description, we might be able to find at runtime. Runtime, is that somewhere here? Okay, let me find it here. Yes, it is exactly here in the Grasshopper active object. So it's another class that we subclass as we subclass the component. All right, beautiful. So that was it. Error handling in native Grasshopper components. Thank you very much. I hope this was useful. If it was, maybe pump, 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 like, sub, sub, sub. And if it wasn't, it's also fine. Let's move on to the next video in this series. Thank you. Bye-bye.